You're not the first man to see it.
He looks different on the telly, doesn't he? Yeah, you go around the other way.
He does look different on the telly. You wouldn't be the first to get... Mel Gibson, 2 years ago, did a tour before he arrived here.
Yeah.
I like the Barney. It's...
Yeah, everyone keeps going on about my hair. Yeah.
Well, I read about you being a blonde.
Yeah, well, I was blonde for the film. Good link, Des.
Yes. Well, we'll talk about the film in a minute. Right. Let's talk about you for a second. By the way, is it more fun being blonde?
It is, yeah, but I can't talk about it on the telly, Des.
Go on, be a devil.
Well, I got my hair dyed blonde, went straight home, and my wife Barbara... no, I can't.
Did you like it? Did it appeal?
Yeah,
I mean, it's
fetching.
It's very fetching.
I keep walking around London and looking at myself on the posters for Mavis Davis, my new film. Yeah. And
we've got that message.
I look at the posters and I say, oh, who's that guy? And you look in the mirror and there's this sad old act. Because I did the bill and I had to have my hair dyed crap for the bill. And... it just makes me look sad, really.
You've done loads of TV. I mean, you've done as much television as most around. You've done... I don't want to make you sound like old Father Time.
Yeah, but it's funny, Des, because you still get really nervous about chat shows. You know, when you...
But you don't seem nervous at the moment.
Well, good. Good actor, you see. No, but it's... the majority of my work is scripted sitcom. Multicam, heavily rehearsed stuff, and then they say, you're going on to meet Des, and we don't meet, you know, we haven't met
yet. It's funny, we have never met.
No.
It's very nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you too.
We have never met, and that's the truth, all these years in the business, we're not met. So we'll put that right.
Can I ask you something, because we haven't met, and I've always wanted to know why Eric Morecambe did all that stuff about you. Were you old pal? I mean, have you been asked that a million times?
We were good mates, and then one day I told him I wanted to be a singer, and he said, well, I'd like to have an affair with Brigitte Bardot, Des. But... He said, all things are not possible, boy. So I said, I'm gonna be a singer. He said, I should join the Royal Ballet. And it never stopped from then, Rick. It just went on and on. This private joke became a national... Somebody put it in the paper and then every cub report in the land was doing. Get back to you.
But you never got sick of it. You never got sick of it. I mean,
Get sick of it. One day at the Palladium at the stage door, a little old lady came up to me and I'd done quite a good show that night. She said, oh, she come here. And she pulled me close. And she said, will you send me your new LP? There's a fiver. So I said, and in those days, they didn't cost a fiver. I'm talking about a long time ago. I said, well, you can get it in the shops for $3.99. She said, I'm not going to go in and ask for it.